get ready to match the stars. Orson Bean, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Mary Wicks, Richard Dawson, and Betty White, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now, here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Rivers!
Thank you, Johnny Olson and friends. Thank you for joining us. We had a good time today.
So we got a good bunch up here. Welcome to you, one and all.
Oh, did you have a nice Christmas?
Yes. Ed, how about you?
Very nice.
And the boys?
Oh, great.
Grand. Everybody else have a good day?
Oh, we had a wonderful time.
Bah, humbug.
Well, bah, humbug. Save it for next year.
No,
well,
I'm not going to do Santa next year either, if you ask me.
No, no, we are going to ask you to do Santa next year.
No, where do you get the letters? The Bissing Link this season. I was wonderful as Santa.
Oh, you were. Indeed you were.
He was, too, and he cried all day
up.
Yesterday.
Right. Now, listen, here, where are we here? We're in the middle of round two. Let's say hello to our two players here, Sandy Fenmore and Jackie Heinsohn. Ready? Sandy's a current champ. She's won $12,500, and she's being challenged by Jackie Heinsohn, who has matched all six celebrities. So when we come to you, my dear, you've got to match all six to achieve a tie and stay in the game. Are you ready for that?
Ready.
You're going to give it a good try, right?
I certainly am.
Okay, we'll see how it turns out right after we see about this. Here we go. Here we go. Push the button. Last round. Sandy, got to match everybody. Listen carefully. Very important to Sandy. Count Dracula said,
I just had a new vehicle made especially for me. I call it the Blankmobile.
You do the cutest imitations. You're so
I love you, my dear. I would like to bite your neck.
Is that all?
Okay, Sandy. Count Dracula said,
I just have a new vehicle made especially for me. I call it the Blankmobile.
The Bloodmobile?
The Bloodmobile is cool. We must have six Bloodmobiles to achieve a tie for that little lady there. You are touching my knee, and I like it.
What do you say, Ors?
Well, she's beautiful and rich, and I'm saying goodbye to her. Bat.
Batmobile is good answer, and that means Jackie Heinsohn. Look at everything. Bat, Bloodmobile, and Bloodmobile. Okay. Congratulations. Okay, hang around on the adhesive tape there. I'll get back to you in a moment or so. I'm going to say goodbye to Sandy. Got to shake your hand because you're a very good game player.
I had a great time.
Good. Sandy Fenmore leaves here with $12,500. There she goes. Here you are. There it is, Captain. Now, that little lady you just left here won a bundle. You could win a bundle, too. You ready?
I sure am.
All right. We polled a recent studio audience, my dear, and we got their best response to this. Day of the blank. Day of the blank. Now, the answer that bunch gave most frequently will get you $500 if you match it, though. Then if you match the next one, you get $250. And the third one will get you $100. And you can get some help here. You may get some good answers from our celebrities. Then again, you may not.
Richard?
Day of the jackal.
Day of the jackal. There's one.
Charles?
Day of the locust.
Day of the locust.
Orson?
Just a very plebeian answer. Day of the week.
Yeah. Day of the week. Now, think about those, Jackie. Day of the jackal, day of the week, and day of the locust. Now, you may want to reject those and give us one of your own. It's entirely up to you.
Okay. I'll take day of the jackal.
You want the day of the jackal. All right, that's the one that Richard gave you. We'll find out if it's up there, and if so, where. Let's begin at the bottom and see if the day of the jackal is under the $100 response. Locust is what we have there. That was Charles' answer.
That bugs me.
Now, may we see if we get a jackal under the $250 number? Yes, we do indeed. Congratulations to you. I have picked up a little more money here. You're up to $350, and before we go on and tell you what happens after that, what do you think is under the big one? Day of the week, Orson's answer? What are they saying over there? Oh, Day of the Dolphin. Oh, yeah.
Oh, sure.
Okay. All right, Earl, slide it. Week is Orson's answer. You know, that rarely happens for the celebrity in the third position to pick an answer, and then it ends up number one up there, but that was not a simple. That was the popular answer. Okay, Day of the Week. Now, Jackie, you've got 250 additional. You're going to play for 10 times that amount, or $2,500, but we can't give you the money, though, until you match somebody. Who do you want to try?
Richard.
Okay. All right, get your ESP going over there to him, and I'll get the $2,500 question and put it to you, and let's see if you collect. Here we go. Cheese and blank. Cheese and blank. Thinking about it now, don't say anything until I ask you, and you got plenty of time now. All right, he's finished. Now, Jackie, think about it, give us an answer which will match Richard's answer. He's already written it and put it in the slot there now. How's your ESP feeling today?
I don't know.
You don't know? What do you say to that? Cheese and?
Crackers.
Cheese and crackers? Well, now the audience reaction indicates that you've done well. We'll find out now from Richard whether you've done well or not. Cheese and crackers, Richard.
What did you have when you came to my house? A little sherry, didn't you?
Yeah, cheese and...
Crackers.
Crackers and sherry. Right, yes. Had the whole thing. Congratulations. Yeah. You got $2,850.
How about that?
I want to see you celebrating here. You got a family down there? Oh, there they are. We'll spin these messages for you, then hurry back and we'll carry on here. Hello there. Now that the Budapest String Quartet has finished the Chopin Prelude, we'll carry on here and say hello to our new player, Gene Hamilton. How are you?
Fine, thank you.
We welcome you.
Thank you. I'm glad to be here.
Good to have you here, Gene. Tell us a little more about yourself.
All right, I'm a working manicurist in Northridge. I'm a magician's assistant. And I'm an amateur ventriloquist. I have two children.
No kidding. Mm-hmm. Are the children the dummies?
No, I have one right here.
Oh, you do that hand puppet in there? Let's just say something without moving your lips, or let him say something without you moving your lips. Watch her now closely.
Hi, I'm Dixie Dog.
Oh, that's not bad. Very good.
Thank you.
Indeed you are. I bet your kids get a big kick out of that. All right, good luck to you, Gene.
Thank
I'll push
you.
This button here. What? And ask you to make a selection, A or B?
I'll choose B.
You want B? Okay. Does he want B?
Yes.
Okay. The warden said to the firing squad.
Yes.
Says, men, the condemned man has made an unusual last request and we must honor it. For the execution, he wants you all to wear blanks. There it is.
The warden said the man, the condemned man, has made an unusual last request, and we must honor just the execution. He wants you all to wear.
Gene, let Mr. Rayburn speak. Don't you do it.
Ready. The warden said to the firing squad, men, the condemned man has made an unusual last request, and we must honor it. For the execution, he wants you all to wear blanks.
Convict outfits. This black and white?
Convict outfits. I think you just lost them.
No!
What would you have said?
Same.
Oh, well, okay. I will only count it as one wrong answer. What do you say?
That's very difficult. The letter M, the letter M is very difficult for a ventriloquist to say.
It is.
Notwithstanding, my firing squad was dressed up in dinner jackets.
Tuxedos or dinner jackets. Okay, there's one answer. Brett, what do you say?
No, Donnie, he wanted to go out with an air of festivity.
Yes?
It was a party. And they all got in their little ball gowns with the bouffant skirts.
Oh! Wouldn't that be wonderful?
Smart.
Ready and fire. What do you say?
Well, you know, the low consciousness of these answers really is stupid. I mean, there's only one answer.
What is the one answer?
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Blind.
There's the definitive answer.
That's the definitive answer.
Charles came up with the definitive answer, Gene Hamilton. We must honor it. For the execution, he wants you all to wear blindfolds, is what he said. She said convict outfits.
Well, I tell you, I'm with Charles all the way. Blindfolds.
Blindfolds, a very good one there.
Yeah, all right.
Now, this is very difficult.
Very difficult, yeah.
I will drink and manipulate the Red Baron here. Oh, get his hat back on, please. It's very difficult. And bees also are very difficult.
Yes.
Blindfold.
Blindfold. Oh, that was terrific.
Thank you. Yeah.
Listen, I think he could have a career in show business, don't you, friends?
You know, I'm doing that now. You didn't know. Yes.
All right, now wait a minute.
He could get club dates anyway.
What do you say? How was he?
Thank you.
Yeah, he's the winner so far.
I've always heard he was better than that. Listen, I was going to do this. My mouse was going to talk, but then it dawned on me, mice can't talk.
Oh.
So he's not going to do it blindfolds.
All right, blindfolds. So there was the answer, Gene. Blindfolds, pretty good there. You ready for yours? Remember the first round ones? A little tougher. And here we go.
I like a challenge myself.
Hey, I got a letter here from camp. A camp letter.
Yes. Oh, I love camp letters.
Even the letters at camp.
I know. Right.
Dear Mom and Dad, everything is fine. Love, Bobby. P.S. I have a pet alligator. I love him. Yesterday, he ate my blank.
I thought you said I'd have a campy letter.
I got a letter from camp.
A lovely girl.
Okay, the answer is yes.
I love you.
All right, now have you got any ideas, Mary?
Yeah, well, I'm not sure it's so good, but I'm kind of fond of it.
That's very good. That's very good there. What do you... Oliver, are you ready? Okay, Jackie. Letter from camp.
Dear Mom and Dad, everything is fine. I love Bobby. P.S. I have a pet alligator. I love him. Yesterday, he ate my blank.
Camp counselor.
Camp counselor is a good one. She said he ate the camp counselor.
Yes, a nasty trick to play. The counselor.
The counselor. One for Jackie. Here's the camp counselor.
He glommed him right up and then went for his roommate.
Oh, the roommate. Yeah. Okay, Charles?
I went along with Orson. I said counselor, too.
Okay. Counselor and roommate are both very good answers there. Yesterday, I have a pet alligator. I love him. Yesterday, ate my camp counselor.
Alligators have that kind of diet. Camp counselor.
There it is. Yeah, three for her.
Counselor
is four. Boy,
that's
good.
Hard. It's
oh, crazy. That is tough. Right.
I gotta get
on. Isn't he marvelous?
Well, he is.
What? It's astounding.
It worries me. You really have hit the bottom of the barrel when you agree with Brett, and that's the second time you've said we had the same.
Ain't the roomie. Okay, so there we are. And round one score is 4-0. Favor the champ. Round two coming up after this. Ready to carry on. Shall we carry on, ladies? Okay. There we go. Round two, final round. Jean, it's up to you.
I'll choose B again.
You want B again? All right. Didn't match anybody first round. Everybody plays this round. Listen carefully. When you go to Benny the Barber, if you tip him good, he parts your hair with a nice clean comb. If you don't tip him, he parts your hair with a blank. There it is, Benny the Barber. You look natty today, Orson. Natty.
If
elegant.
You tip him well, not good.
That's right.
Oh.
Writers, if you tip him well, he parts your hair with a nice clean comb. Okay, here we go. Walk over here to Gene Hamilton and friend.
Tip him.
Is your friend ready?
Yes.
Is it easy for him?
Yes.
It's difficult for me.
Yeah.
Easy for you?
Yes.
Oh, good. Listen. When you go to Benny the Barber, if you tip him good, he parts your hair with a nice queen comb. If you don't tip him, he parts your hair with a blank. What do you say to that?
A razor.
A razor. Part your hair? A razor. She said a razor. You ready for that? Okay, Orson, you're up.
I am truly ashamed of my response.
Why?
I have, because it's a matter of total indifference. It's an object of widespread revulsion. It will be a rake.
A rake? I believe. Now, wait a minute, he doesn't know. He missed the point, but he's batting very well. His percentage is very high. No one bats a thousand.
When he fails, he does it. So, I mean, outrageously.
He did it gracefully, didn't he? What do you say?
No, he didn't do it gracefully at all. I said, now this may be a mess. I don't want to have to get ugly about it. I said a very sharp razor.
Oh, that is a mess.
Clear cut, simple, and well done.
What is that? That's a razor. Oh, oh.
It's a crocodile.
Razor. Oh, yeah. One man, his lips didn't move, the cigar moved, but the lips didn't move at all. If you don't tip and part your hair with a razor. That really surprised me. Got two out of that so far. How you doing, honey?
Well, listen, honey, I'm doing all right. I'm getting better and better paper dyes as I go along.
Oh, yeah.
Now then, if he gets mad at you, you know what he does?
What?
He parts your hair with a meat cleaver.
A meat cleaver.
Well, you haven't been there.
Score is now 4-2. We have two remaining celebrities to be heard from, Gene. You must match both of them to stay in the game. An axe. Yeah. We're moving off. That means straight range over there. Missed it by one. Jackie wins the game. Come on down. Here we go again. All right. Well, it was a pleasure to meet you and your friend, Gene.
Well, nice meeting you. I was very happy to be here.
And we've got a lot of gifts for you.
Thank you.
We've got thanks to Gene Hamilton for being with us here on Match Game 76. Goodbye. Now, here we are. You got, you're up to $2,958. You just picked up an extra $100. Now you can pick up a lot more if it works well for you. Ready?
Yes.
Okay. We polled a studio audience here not too long ago, and we got their best response to this. Kent Blank. Remember how it goes? $500 for the answer they gave most often. $250 for their second most frequent response. And if you match that bottom one, you get $100, okay? Now let's see what kind of help we'll get over here.
Orson?
Well, I'll take it. I was torn between Kent Do It and Kent Cigarettes. Kent Cigarettes.
Kent Cigarettes. All right. One.
Charles?
Kent Clark.
He said it without moving his lips. Very well done.
Kent Clark.
Kent Clark.
Kent Clark.
Okay, right. Thank you. One more.
Richard.
Kent McCord.
Yeah, listen, he didn't move your lips, but I couldn't understand what to say. Didn't
understand.
What?
I'll try it again. Cheer me.
Kent?
McCord.
Okay. Kent Cigarettes, Kent Clark, Kent McCord. You want one of those?
I'll go with Kent McCord.
You go with Kent McCord?
He's very happy.
All right.
Wait, he is a nice guy.
Wait,
wait,
what?
I had the glove on the wrong side. It should have been on here. It's not Clark Kent. It's Kent Clark or Clark Kent.
That's right. You blew it.
But you didn't catch it, and so that's showbiz.
She didn't choose it anyway. She chose Kent McCord. We'll find out if it's up there. Let's begin down at the bottom and reveal the $100 number. Kent State.
Oh,
yes, indeed. All right. Now, we're looking for Kent McCord. May we see the $250 number? Cigarettes are there. All right, last chance for Kent McCord. Here we go. McCord it is. Very good. Now, pick up another $500. And before we go on here, we got to stop and do a little business with America, and then we're going to see if we come back and win the big amount. Okay? Here you go. Gene Mariner, join us next time, Match 176. Goodbye!